Good afternoon. How's everyone doing today? Good. My name is Dr. Bruce Locklear, and I am the interim head of school here at New Life Academy. And on behalf of our faculty and staff, we would like to say welcome and thank you for coming. Not that you would ever miss it, but braving the elements to get here is a big thing. We're just so excited for today, and I must admit, I am a grandparent for the first time. It's awesome. And she's 20 months old, and my daughter's about to have a second one, so it's going to be twice over. And so as a grandparent, I didn't get it. I did not get it because everyone told me, this is the best thing ever. It's the best thing ever. And I'll share a quick story and then talk some about the program, but just the importance of grandparents in the life of our children. My granddaughter was here yesterday, and we were speaking during our all-school chapel, and, Papa, Papa! So my heart melted. So thank you, and God bless you for being grandparents, and I'm honored to be a part of that club. But to talk about the show today, our students have worked so hard, and we're just so excited for their presentation today, and they're excited to share it with you. So if you would join me in prayer as we take some time to get ready for today. Heavenly Father, we're so honored and so thankful to be in your presence, and so humbled each and every day to be a part of New Life Academy. Father, the work that you are placing on the hearts and the minds of people in this school, it just is so heartwarming and refreshing. But most importantly, it's hopeful. Father, we have the opportunity to lead children in a spiritual journey for Jesus Christ. And we also have the opportunity to develop tomorrow's leaders today. And the most important aspect of that, Father, is that we're developing them and growing them in your word and in your way. Now, Father, I just pray a blessing over our little ones today as they take the stage and as they rejoice with parents and grandparents alike today, the beauty of this story. Father, in thy name we pray and we give everything up to you. Amen.
can't believe it's almost Christmas.
I know. Only 2 more days till Christmas and 1 more day till we get to perform a show on Main Street.
This is so cool. I bet we'll have lots and lots of people there because the stores will just have closed.
And all those people buying all those last-minute gifts will walk over.
Speaking of gifts, does your family open gifts on Christmas Eve or do they make you wait till Christmas morning?
We open them Christmas Eve.
Yeah!
Oh, you're so lucky. At my house, we have to wait till Christmas. We have to wait till all the grown-ups wake up. And finish their breakfast. And sip their coffee. It drives us crazy.
We've all been waiting 363 days for Christmas.
Remain inactive until something anticipating occurs.
A strong feeling of distaste or dislike.
To enthusiastically enjoy with great fonts.
Christmas! December 25th to celebrate the anniversary of Christ's birth.
Almost here.
You guys,
terrible news. The town must have a pageant in the square tomorrow. The mayor just decided.
Now. Oh, wait a minute, boys and girls. I don't want you telling your moms and dads that I said you can't have the pageant in the square tomorrow.
So we can have the pageant tomorrow?
Well, no, you can't.
What? Why?
I'm afraid the town square isn't such a great idea.
What?
Boys and girls, I'm getting a level with you. My latest poem shows, 1, I look better in red power ties. 2, parking meters should be free on weekends. And 3, your show is just going to cause a lot of traffic problems. Oh yeah, that's it, traffic. But maybe next year you can, if you make a few changes, you know, make it a bit more hip, happening, rad. Isn't that you, kids, eh?
What?
Kids, you have to admit, the major scene is a little bit too old-fashioned.
What?
You can't argue with public opinion, especially at this time of year, with my re-election coming up. Sorry, kids. Say hi to your moms and dads for me. Oh, and make sure for them to get out of vote. Gotta run this time of year. Bye.
Can't do that. We've been planning this for months and all those rehearsals.
I guess he can because he just did. We need to find another place.
No, we can't. It's too late. I don't care what the poll said. I don't even know what a poll is. Let's get everyone in the neighborhood to help. You know, to call the town hall and get him to change his mind.
Yeah, good idea. But how do we reach everyone? Time is too short and tomorrow's our show.
Hey, I have an idea. Let's all go Christmas caroling right now.
Hey, yeah, we can go door to door to get all the neighbors out. The show must go on.
can get lots of people there. Our show is a message that God wants everybody to hear. Let's go. To the right.
Wow, look over there. That house has the fanciest decorations I've ever seen.
Look at how bright and cheery it is. It's all decked out for Christmas.
I'm sure whoever lives there loves Christmas. They would love our show. Well then, here we go. Somebody ring the doorbell.
Look, Thurston, aren't they adorable? How quaint.
Please, children, you're standing on the lawn. Watch out for the lights. The gardener spent hours putting those up. Don't break.
Do you think they want money?
I'll give them $5 and see if they'll go away.
Here you are, little darlings.
We don't want your money.
Don't want money? All kids want money at Christmas time. All kids want money all the time.
No, we need your help. We would like it if you would call the mayor and ask him to let us perform a Christmas show.
Did he finally cancel that thing? Good for him. I've been after him for weeks to do that. Sorry, kids, but the traffic your pageant will cause is a nightmare.
Really, children? I'm sure the pageant is sweet, but it kind of belongs in the church, not the town square. Your moms and dads will understand, and you will too when you grow up. Ta-ta! I hope they don't trample on our beautiful decorations.
I'll sue them if they do.
Wow, that was so unexpected.
What do you mean? Why do they have all those decorations and lights if they don't like Christmas?
Oh, they like Christmas. They just don't understand the true meaning of Jesus' birth.
Without Jesus, you'll never understand, you'll never know the heart of Christmas.
Kind of empty, 'cause without Jesus, they'll never understand, they'll never know the heart. of Christmas.
Okay, we'll just have to try harder. That's all.
Right, pick ourselves up and get back at it. Next house.
Wow, this house has lots of fun lights and flags and all different kinds of stuff. Well then, go ahead, ring the doorbell.
How cool. It's a Christmas thing. What did they call that again?
Oh, wait. It's on the tip of my tongue. It's the Scrooge thing. No. Careening thing? No. Carousing thing? No, no, no.
Wait. I've got it. Caroling. That's it. Christmas carols. They sound different when you see someone real singing them. It's much better than the music at the mall.
Ma'am, sir, we need your help.
We are the kids who are supposed to perform our Christmas pageant on the square on Main Street tomorrow night.
Oh yeah, how cute.
Are you planning on joining us this year?
Sure we will, dude. We go to all the holiday events all around. We celebrate all the holidays too.
Flag Day.
Earth Day.
Groundhog's Day. Won't want to leave any out.
Wouldn't want to hurt anybody's feelings.
Besides, who knows which holiday story is right?
Gotta keep your bases covered, bro.
Trying to keep us from doing our show tomorrow. Will you call him and ask him to let us do it?
Please.
That doesn't seem fair.
Everybody should get to do their holiday thing, no matter what they believe.
Okay, we'll call. Season's greetings. Bye-bye now.
Are you really going to call?
Of course not. We don't want to get involved. Shh.
I bet they get a lot of presents.
Well, what do they really believe?
A little bit of everything.
Well, if you believe in everything, then you don't really believe in anything.
I'm glad I know what I believe.
To be deceived, I know I.
this house only has a wreath on the door. It's pretty, but it doesn't seem like they're really into Christmas.
You didn't just say that, did you? Did you learn anything from the last two stops? The outside doesn't always match up with the inside.
That's for sure.
Well, only one way to find out. Ring that bell.
Away in a Manger? Oh, that's my favorite Christmas carol. You guys sound so wonderful. Thank you for coming to sing for me.
Are you all alone?
Oh, no. My children are small, so they are sleeping. They would have loved to hear you. Their daddy is in the Air Force, so he can't be here this Christmas, and I couldn't put up the lights all by myself. But we're not alone, and their daddy isn't alone either. Somehow we feel together. I'm sure that's because of Jesus, and your children just reminded me of that. Thank you. What can I give you? Some hot cocoa?
Help with something.
What, children? What can I do for you?
Well, we're supposed to perform a Christmas show in the town square tomorrow.
Oh, yes. I saw the signs and we're planning on being there.
Well, right now, it's been canceled. The mayor won't let us do it.
What?
The mayor said that the square would be too busy, too much traffic.
He also said his re-election was soon, and he didn't want anything with the manger scene.
And he said it wasn't hip or happening.
Oh my, no manger scene, but that's where Christmas began, with the birth of Jesus. He knows that.
Will you call Town Hall and ask him to change his mind?
Yes, I will. This is too important.
You just wouldn't believe how many grown-ups don't know about Jesus.
You just got to tell them.
Yes, you do. I'll call there right now. Don't worry. I've got a good connection down at Town Hall. Thanks, boys and girls. God bless, and I'll see you tomorrow night at the town square on Main Street.
It's gonna take a miracle for that to happen.
Christmas is all about miracles.
Well, wow, that lady was so different from anybody else we've met today.
Come on, guys. Look at the rest of the houses on the street. We've got work to do.
Okay, I give up. Mr. Mayor? Boys and girls, it wasn't bad enough that my phone has been ringing all afternoon. And now you get my daughter to call?
Your daughter? What do you mean?
Well, you kids must have gone Christmas caroling to every house on Main Street today.
We got as many as we could.
Well, I sure got a lot of calls, but that wasn't the worst part, though. When my daughter called and asked me to let the show go on, she likes all that shepherds, wise men, manger stuff. She says it's an important part of her faith. I just can't say no to her, especially at this time of year with her husband away in the Air Force and all.
That lady is your daughter?
My pride and joy. She said all she wanted for Christmas this year was to see me at the pageant in the square. Well, I know I'm going to lose a few votes over this, but it's back on. You guys can use the square.
Yay!
Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
There is a candle in every soul, some brightly burning, some dark and cold.
so many people are here. And look, there's a mayor and his daughter right in the front row.
It's another Christmas miracle.
Hurry up, everybody. Do you have your wings? Brandon, where's your mirror?
I wonder how many people that we sang to yesterday will actually come.
How many people are there?
1, 2, 3. Gazillions, come on, let's get started.
Places, places, everybody. 3, 2, 1, go on, Hunter King.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to our Main Street Christmas pageant. The birth of Jesus took place over 2,000 years ago, and they didn't have cell phones or pagers, so please turn them off. Merry Christmas.
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world.
So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because it belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary. She was pledged to Miriam, who was expecting a child.
While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no room available for them in the inn.
And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were so afraid.
And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord.
And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men.
Thank you.
think it's been 20 years since I actually listened to that story, since my daughter was little and was in these things. I've gotten distracted by all the malls and the music. I feel like that stem comes earlier every year.
You know why that is?
Why?
Because this old world is so hungry for the message of Christmas, they can't get it soon enough. One of these years, the malls are going to start decorating for Christmas right after the 4th of July. The world just gets the message of Christ confused with the shopping and gift-giving thing. But boys and girls, you just made the Christmas story sparkling and crystal clear tonight.
I don't care if I do lose a few votes over this, but I think the community needs to hear this message every year. You know what, boys and girls? Next year, I want to be in the pageant. I want to be a wise man. Can I audition?
Yeah!
Well, it's Christmas Eve, and I bet your families are waiting for you. And you know what? No gift could be as nearly as precious as what you kids just gave us tonight. You stood up for what you believed in, and you told us all what we need to hear.
I think we just witnessed a real miracle on Main Street.
Another incredible, wonderful, beautiful Christmas miracle.
I'm gonna cry. You guys did So good. Oh, good job. Sorry. Thank you for coming so much and listening to our great kids. Just a couple of housekeeping things, and thank you, Miss Allard. She just did an incredible job. So a couple housekeeping things. We're going to, after I pray, we're going to send the kids up to their rooms. So if you would please meet them up in their rooms, and please, you are invited to come and have a little treat and some fellowship time in the worship center with us and that. But we just, I know it's Friday the 13th, it's full moon, it's a snowstorm and that. But you know, God is good, and he can take us through all of that. So we're so thankful that you're here today. And thank you for entrusting your kids to us. It's just such a privilege for us to be able to do that. And I know that teachers feel that way. So let's just bow our head. Oh, yes. Okay.
Sorry, before we pray, if you were so wonderful and donated any props or anything like that, please pick those up before you leave so that I don't have to track you down. Thank you.
All right, let's bow our heads. Precious Heavenly Father, Lord, we lift this all up to you. Lord, these kids now have these songs and these words and this scripture in their hearts. And Lord, we just know that you loved us so much that you sent us this humble little baby to be born, that would grow up and to sacrifice his life for us. And Lord, I just pray as we go throughout this season now that you will just keep that first and foremost in our hearts and minds as all the activities and all the great things are happening. And Lord, we just pray for travels, that there be safety, and Lord, for time with family and friends would just be blessed. Lord, be with us now as we leave this place. And we pray these things in your Son, Jesus Christ's name. Amen. So thank you again for coming. Really appreciate it.